These two examples will emphasize the difference between inverse and reciprocal. Assume f of x is a 1-to-1 function and f of negative 2 is equal to 7. We want to determine each value here on the left. And the notation here is extremely important. This negative 1 here indicates inverse function notation. This is f inverse of 7. This negative 1 here is an exponent. So to evaluate this, we find the value of f of negative 2 and then raise it to the power of negative 1, which would be equal to the reciprocal of f of negative 2. So if we go back up to the given information, we're told f of negative 2 equals 7. Another way to show this relationship would be to map this, meaning for function f, if the input is negative 2, the rule is the output will be positive 7. And again, this is for function f. Well, f inverse will undo function f, which means f inverse will map positive 7 back to negative 2. Which means if we map f inverse, if the input is positive 7, then the output would be negative 2 for f inverse. So f inverse of 7 is equal to negative 2. And then for our second example, we first need to find the value of f of negative 2, which is given. It's equal to positive 7. So this is equal to 7 raised to the power of negative 1, which is equal to the reciprocal of 7, which is 1/7. Another way to think of this is, you could put this over 1 to make it a fraction. Then if this crosses the fraction bar, it's going to change the sign of the exponent, so this would be equal to 1/7. I hope this explanation helps.